Hello, and welcome to my first comic book video. I just want to introduce myself a little bit about how I got interested in comic books and give some information on how I was able to start collecting and some ideas on how somebody who is new and interested in comic books might start looking into comic books. So first of all, let me introduce a little bit about myself. I'm a 30-something middle-aged man with a family. And I grew up in the 90s with Batman the Animated Series and X-Men, and I loved superheroes, but I never really was into comic books themselves. I had a couple of friends that owned comic books, that bought comic books, and I would grab them off the shelf, but I never owned a comic book myself. I've always had an interest in them. I've always, every once in a while, if I'm out and I drive past a comic book shop, I would stop. You know, you see the comics is normally what it says on the side of the building. And I'd stop and I'd go look in and I'd walk in and somebody would say, "Can I help you?" And I didn't even know where to start. So that's a situation that I found myself in maybe once every 4 years over the past 20 years or so. And I had never purchased a comic book in a comic shop up until last year. But that all changed. The first comic book that I ever bought is this X-Men Gold number one in front of you now. And I bought this comic book not because I wanted to start collecting comic books, but because I've always been very interested in politics and pop culture and where they come into contact. And this book popped up in a conversation about some outrage that it generated, because apparently inside of it, and I have looked inside, I do know what's there, but the artist snuck in a couple of references that you might consider anti-Semitic. They're definitely a little bit interesting. And when I heard about it, and I caught on to the outrage about it, and heard that the artist was fired, that was all very funny to me, and I said, this has to go into my collection of pop culture generating outrage. I have a couple of other things that goes into that collection. So I didn't even know where to get this book. I ended up buying it on eBay. I definitely overpaid for it because I wasn't interested in investing or collecting comic books. I just wanted this book to be a part of a separate collection of things. And I bought it. I bought it in April of 2017. And it was the very first comic book that I've ever owned. I didn't have it. Luckily, it came in a bag and board. I didn't even know that's what you were supposed to do with them. So it was all very, very new to me. But I grabbed it, and because I had searched on Google for this, and because I had bought something from eBay, all of the sudden, I started to get advertisements and recommended videos and just bombarded with all of this information, especially because of politics in comic books. Now, for those that have been around for the last couple of years, of course, you probably know exactly what I'm talking about. And that was all very interesting, and I started to learn a little bit about what was going on in the comics industry. But at the same time, I was also learning what was great about comic books, the books themselves. And, you know, I'm a middle-aged man, as I said, and, you know, my life is starting to get pretty comfortable, but it's been devoted up to this point on, you know, developing my career and my family. And now those things are kind of stable and I have a little bit of extra income, and I thought it's time for me to get some hobbies. And I thought comic books might be just the thing. Now, I wasn't sure that I was fully committed to it or what I was going to do, but I thought I'd give it a try. It definitely seemed like something that was acceptable and could potentially be interesting to talk about. So I started to research how to get into comic books. And I read a lot of different things. I didn't know what kind of comic books to buy, what I was looking for. I didn't know where to enter in. But so I read, first of all, I read that the DC Universe had reset recently in 2016, I believe, and that it was a good place to jump in. And then I read somewhere else that there were a couple of things to keep in mind to keep yourself from getting overwhelmed when you start to get into comic books, because apparently a lot of people stop because either they start spending too much money too early on, or because they just can't keep up. They end up getting too many books and they don't read them and then they just stop. So I read and two things stood out to me. One was, pick a story that you like and go with that. And the other was pick an artist that you like and seek them out. So as I had read, the DC Universe had just reset. I walked into a comic book shop and I kind of had already decided that Batman has always been my favorite comic book character. I know that's kind of cheesy. He's the least superhero of the superheroes, but I've always liked him. Obviously, I liked the Batman movies, from the Tim Burton to the more recent ones. And so I went into the store and I looked at Batman, and I think this was the week that Batman 26 had come out. And I saw 26 on the shelf in the new comic books, and I saw 25 in the back issues. And I said, this is a good place to start. I committed, I said, okay, I'm going to buy all of these comic books. I'm going to go get the back issues from 1 to 26. I'm going to read them all, and I'm going to read them by the time that 27 comes out. And that's going to be how I start getting into this. Going to go 1 to 27 and figure out what's going on with Batman. Now, this was just purely by luck. There were a lot of Batmans on the shelf. I could have grabbed Detective Comics. I could have grabbed All-Star Batman was there. I didn't know what those were, what the difference between the Batman titles was. There's Batman Beyond as well, which I knew was something different, but I didn't know exactly what. But I picked up Batman 26 mostly because it was the plainest title, Batman. Didn't know much about it. But then I started, so I start went to through the comic shop. This is the first time I'd been in a comic shop in a couple of years. First time that I ever bought anything from a comic shop. And I think I bought 26 and 25, and I went back into their back issues, and I was able to get like 19, 20, 21, 22. No, I wasn't able to get 21. But I grabbed a bunch of books. And then I went to, I did a couple of Google searches, and I found another local comic shop that I could go into, and I grabbed all of the back issues that were there. And then I found one more, and I grabbed even some more back issues there. And I was able to pick up from three local comic shops most of the back issues from 1 to 25. But there was one issue that I could not find anywhere, and that was this one, number 24. And that is really what kind of sealed the deal, is I had to figure out what was going on with 24. And I wasn't into the news. I had no idea what was going on. And so I just had to buy this book and I ordered it online. And I was like, this book is way too expensive. I think I paid $20 for it, something like that. But it was, this was my goal. This was how I was going to enter into comic books. I bought it and it came and I read all of the books up to it. And I was like, whoa. Okay, this is iconic. This is something new. This is something interesting that's happening. So that kind of locked me into buying Batman. And I can say up to this week, I'm still buying this Batman series. I've bought every one. I went through the wedding issue and the fiasco that happened there, and I wasn't that upset with it. But I started buying Batman. That was the first set of books that I bought, and I've been buying them since. So that 24 was the book that kind of locked everything in place for me to keep buying Batman, and I'm going through that too today. Now, the other thing that I read when I was getting started with comic books was you should pick an artist to follow. And I had no idea what that even meant. I remembered a conversation that I had heard from a couple years ago. Somebody was talking about iconic costumes for female comic book characters. And it was in the same vein of the outrage and the complaining about modern, or complaining about female comic book outfits. So this person was talking about two iconic costumes that they were talking about. And they talked about Batgirl, and they showed this image on the video that I was watching. And they talked about Catwoman, and they showed an Adam Hughes Catwoman cover. And I didn't know anything about them, but I loved this Batgirl. And I said, okay, that's the one I'm gonna go get. And I looked up, okay, so who is this artist? It's Art Germ, obviously. And so I searched, okay, so who is Art Germ? And I found out that he was just getting ready to start the Supergirl run that he did from Supergirl 12. I said, okay, so that's cool. I can start picking up some Art Germ stuff. I looked up this book online and I think it was around $50 at the time, and I wasn't ready to put $50 to a comic book at that point. But I picked the artist that I was going to follow. Now that was really interesting because if I had gone just a little bit different, maybe I would have picked Adam Hughes and I would be in a totally different boat. But I loved Art Germ. And this was the book that pulled me in and had me start buying Art Germ books. It wasn't until January of this year that I finally picked up Batgirl 12 along with the rest of his Batgirl run. And I've really enjoyed collecting the Art Germ books. I have a really special one coming in a couple of days, one that's the most that I've spent on a comic book so far, but I'm happy about that, and I will show something when I get that one here. But this is how I approached getting into comic books, and it's been really fun. You know, I've picked up other series along the way. Because I read Batman and I learned to appreciate Tom King's character-driven storytelling, I started reading Mr. Miracle as well, and that was fantastic. Until I didn't like the end, and I actually didn't finish it because at book 10 or 11, I didn't like it too much. But, you know, I read Mr. Miracle, and I read, started reading the entire Dark Knight's Metal. I read Batman White Knight by Sean Gordon Murphy, and, you know, I just started picking up all of these different books. Now, you can tell these first books that I picked up were mostly DC. For me, DC was a lot easier to get into. I picked up a Marvel book here and there, and there really was this every single book demonstrated a little bit of you know, that social awareness, the a little bit of not quite, I wouldn't call it political ranting because most of them really are apolitical, but they just every single one has, you know, people standing around talking about you know, something that would come out of the mouth of people who are politically charged. And that took me a while to get into. So I didn't buy any really any Marvel books for quite a while. I think I finally started getting into Marvel with Thanos 13 because I heard really good things about the Thanos Wins run. So I bought Thanos 13 and that turned out to be a very good purchase. And then I got into Venom and because of Donny Cates. And so now I'm buying a little bit more Marvel, but still not very much. Most of what I buy and read is from DC. But so that's the story of how I got into comic books. And really, I think it was an excellent way to approach it, to step in lightly. Since then, I've probably got 400 books now. I've changed the way that I buy books a little bit in the past, and I have a different direction that I'm going with how I'm building my collection. But two parts that will always be in my collection is I'm going to go all the way through this Batman run, and I'm going to pick up every Art Germ book I can get. I think that's a fantastic, fun way to get into to comic books, and that's what I would recommend to anybody who's interested. Now, it might be hard to find a starting point, so I was thinking right now, so it is December 1st, 2018. If you wanted to start at a number one, things are a little bit tricky. I might starting with Venom number one. I think we're on Venom number seven right now, so there's not a whole lot of back issues. A couple of those are going to be hard, but you should be able to get second prints fairly inexpensively to get the story. It's interesting, and there's a lot of new stuff in there. The people who are most interested are into the backstory and all the stuff that built into it, but it's still very good. Venom is a good place to start. And if you're looking for covers, the great thing about comic book covers and the reason that I like buying comic book covers is because really, if you're paying cover price for it, if it's a new book and you go into the shop and you see that picture and you're like, that is a great cover, you've spent $4 on a piece of art. $4 to $5. And to me, that's reasonable. If it's something that I like and I'm spending $4 just for the art, great. If the story's excellent, fantastic. But if it's just a piece of art, that's acceptable. So it's been fun to buy cover books. I've spread out a little bit. I've tried a few, but I still don't like anybody quite as much as consistently as I like Art Germ. I do like Adam Hughes. That's going to get expensive if that's somebody that you're interested in. I like Francesco Mattina. His books are very interesting. He's got a lot of inexpensive books right now that are easy to get a hold of, but he has some very expensive books from a few years ago. Delotto's the same way. He has a lot of exclusives that are very expensive. I like In Hayek Lee, some of his stuff. He's not quite as consistent, but he does have some great stuff. There are a couple of new artists that are possibly worth getting into. Some of them are getting pretty expensive, but Joshua Middleton, fantastic covers, and fairly recent, from what I understand, mostly new stuff from this current run of DC Universe. And oh, who was the other one? Oh, Yasmine Putri, who I learned worked with Art Germ on a couple of the older covers. So I was already familiar with Yasmine Putri's work because I was buying Art Germ books. But she's getting very popular right now, and her covers are beautiful, and her art is beautiful. From what I understand, she just did some interior work for another book that I'm going to go grab just because it's got her art in it. So that's what I would recommend if you are interested in starting to get into comic books now, as of January 1st. Now, as I go forward, I'm going to show a couple of the other strategies that I have for how I've purchased books and what I'm doing with them, and also how I sell them, how I try to keep myself balanced and keep my budget reasonable. And I intend to give away a lot of books. I don't have a contest built up right now, but I have a couple of duplicates and some interesting books that, I might be able to sell for possibly $20, but at $20 a book, once you talk about shipping and fees and everything else, it's barely worth it. So I've got some books in that kind of range that I think are fun to collect that I'm gonna include as contests. So stay tuned. Let me know who you are, what you think, give me any recommendations. I am not an expert on comic books. I am not a gatekeeper of any sort. I don't know what all the characters are, what the history is, but I do think that it's a fun hobby and it's something that anybody can get into. And that's something that I really like, and that is one of the reasons that I want to enter into the community of people who are involved with comic books and bring more people into this community. So thanks for watching. I will have more videos. Subscribe and you'll start to see my contest as soon as they start to come up, and I appreciate it.